हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द चैनल। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट मोबाइल कंप्यूटिंग, व्हिच इज द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, दैट इज आईटी, फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ मोबाइल कंप्यूटिंग। सो दिस आर द टेबल्स ऑफ कंटेंट व्हिच आर वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट और व्हिच आर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ मोबाइल कंप्यूटिंग, वायरलेस कम्युनिकेशन, एप्लीकेशन सेलुलर सिस्टम कम्युनिकेशन और एप्लीकेशन सेलुलर कम्युनिकेशन फ्रॉम फर्स्ट जनरेशन टू फोर्थ जनरेशन। आफ्टर दैट GSM, वॉट इज GSM, आफ्टर दैट सिस्टम आर्किटेक्चर प्रोटोकॉल, लोकलाइजेशन एंड कॉलिंग इन द GSM सिस्टम, हैंड ओवर इन द GSM और द सिक्योरिटी विच इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द GSM। सो वॉट इज मोबाइल कंप्यूटिंग? I think everyone is most familiar with the mobile, how we are going to use the mobile, how you can manage your different connectivities with all other electronic devices. So, what is mobile computing? The human or computer interaction in which a computer is expected to transport it during normal uses. Means, we can connect number of devices for the communication or the peripheral use of the devices. So what mobile computing do or how you can learn, what you are going to learn in this subject or in the mobile computing? In this mobile computing, what you are actually going to learn? You are going to learn mobile communication, how the communication is establishing, about what services establishing with the mobile hardware or the software. So the mobile computing, that is technology, which allows the transmission of data, not only the data but also the audio, video via computer or any other wireless devices. That is, the mobile computing provides the ability to use technology in remote or mobile environments or a computing environment over the physical mobility. So this is overall about mobile computing, what is mobile computing or how we can communicate with one device to another device, that is how we can share information from one device to another device. So this is the normal short definitions of mobile computing. So you can see here number of devices, that is mobile phone, cell phone, laptops, modems, everything is connected to the mobile computing or the mobile for the communication purpose. We can access information from any device or we can transfer any information to the another device just for the communication purpose. So there are some of the aspects which is provided by the mobility, that is user mobility and the device mobility. So what is user mobility? These are the two aspects of mobility. So what is user mobility? User mobility in the sense, user who have access to similar communication services at the different places. Means the user can access any information, any suitable information from anywhere, everywhere, at any time. It means in the example or in the diagram, you can see the user can access any information at the sitting in the restaurant or in the office, or in the supermarket or the house. Means the user can sit in the house and access any information or search any information related to supermarket or any information related to office or official information research after sitting in the house. So user can retrieve any information or access any information related to his search or his need. After that, device portability. What is device portability? Device portability means the user can carry out any device from any place, that is one place to another place, he can carry out any physical object. That is, for example, we have a mobile phone, that is cell phones or the laptops, we can carry out for the one place to another place. So there were no any need of electrical conductor or any wired communication or the wired aid network, but with the help of wireless communication we can access any information. But while going for the lab computer, that is computers, monitors, so we need electrical conductor to connect that application or connect that device or the connect that embedded system. We need electrical conductor. But the device portability means we can carry out any physical object from one place to another place without electrical conductor. So that is device portability. After that, wireless communication. what is wireless communication, what are the types of wireless communication we are going to discuss here. Wireless communication is the transfer of information between two or more points that do not use an electrical conductor. I already told you what is wireless communication or what is mobile computing do. Mobile computing establish a communication between one device to another device. So wireless communication is the transfer of information between two or more points that do not use electrical conductor. Means there were no need of electrical wire for the communication. So the different types of wireless communications are satellite communication, infrared communication, broadcast radio, microwave communication, Wi-Fi, mobile communication system, Bluetooth technology. So satellite technology, in the sense we can access any information from the ground stations. Infrared communication means the signals which providers the systems which are the infrared for the communications. Broadcast radio, that is we are accessing any frequency for the music, roadway, current location situations or the news, etc. Then microwave communication, Wi-Fi communication or the mobile communication system means we can share any information, that is a voice, audio, messages, SMS. These all are services provided by the mobile computing. So this is up to Bluetooth technology. So further topics we will cover in the next video. Thank you.